الحمد لله الذي فضل علينا بكثرة الأنبياء والمرسلين وجعلنا من أمته سيد الأولين والآخرين حبيب إله العالمين الذي كان نبيا وآدم بين الماء والطين شفيع المذنبين أبي القاسم محمد وجعلنا من المتمسكين بولاية أمير المؤمنين سيد الوصيين أفضل المجاهدين أول الصادقين أبي الحسنين نور الشهدين غالب كل غالب علي بن أبي طالب وعلى آلهم الطيبين الطاهرين المعشومين المظلومين لا سيما بقية الله في الأرضين أرواحنا لتراب مقدمه الفدا الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا ولعنة الدائمة السرمدية على أعدائهم وقتلتهم وغاصب حقوقهم ومنكر فضائلهم ومناقبهم من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي أما بعد فقد قال إمامنا الرضا عليه الصلاة والسلام يا أبا هاشم العقل حباء من الله والأدب كلفة صدق إمامنا الرضا عليه الصلاة والسلام On this blessed occasion of the Wiladat of our 8th Holy Imam, Imam Ali ibn Musa al-Ridha, alayhi afdal al-salati wa salam. I send my heartiest felicitations to Imam of our time, Hujjat ibn al-Hasan, sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman, alayhi salam. To all the mu'mineen and mu'minat gathered here and worldwide. And I pray to Almighty Allah that in the name of the 8th Imam, may Almighty Allah grant all the desires of all the mu'mineen, and may Almighty Allah grant us the ziyarat of Imam al-Ridha in this world and his shafa'ah in the hereafter, and may hasten the reappearance of the 12th Imam Hujjat ibn al-Hasan, sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman alayhi salam. وجعلنا من أعوانه وأنصاره وشيعته ومحبيه والثائرين تحت لوائه والمستشهدين بين يديه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين Human always plans to improve himself whether financially whether spiritually. Of course, financially, we try to understand, we try to learn, and we try to graduate, and then we try to find some work, or some people go into businesses. And of course, some fail and some succeed. And then we still fail to understand the reason of failure, and we still fail to understand the reason of success. Those who are successful, they think that there is that knowledge that they had gathered, that was the period of success. But all of a sudden it comes a time when there is a downfall again, and then the person forgets, and then he realizes that it was not what he was that gave him success. It is something else, that secret which is hidden, which a person has to find out what is the secret behind the success. That's the same thing basically on the spiritual level. On the spiritual level, we normally don't see things. We want to improve ourselves, but we don't know how to improve. We don't know ourselves, and therefore we wouldn't know how to improve ourselves. We wouldn't know what is our goal and where we are going, that we should be able to decide what is the best way to go further. So the only method we have selected is an intellectual method of understanding and learning. And we thought that that is the way how a person could improve even spiritually. But Imam al-Ridha alayhi afdal as-salatu was-salam, in this hadith, the 8th Imam alayhi salatu was-salam breaks down the human success into two sections. And he says, what should be improved and how should be improved? And what will bring about the success? The secret is hidden in the hadith that I'm going to recite in front of you, which I started with in Arabic, and I will translate to you, inshallah, if you recite one loud salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. He calls Abu Hashim. Abu Hashim is one of the companions of the 8th Imam. And he says, Abu Hashim al-Ja'fari, Ya Abu Hashim, al-Aql hiba'un min Allah. Intelligence, reason, aql is a gift from Allah. It's not an acquisition. Sometimes you see some child is very intelligent. We don't know the reasons. Sometimes they just excel. Some are totally dumb when their parents were very intelligent. Basically, the 8th Imam says the intelligence is not it cannot be acquired. It is a gift from Allah. He says, حِبَاءٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ. It's a gift from Allah. وَالْأَدَبُ كُلْفَةٌ. Then he breaks it down. The intelligence and the reason and the aql is different. Which is the gift from Allah? And remember, gift is something that does not come daily. It is granted only on two occasions. One occasion is when a person is entitled for the gift. Say for example, a child recites a beautiful dua the first time, a small child. His age and his sound and his practice and his ability shows us and makes us pull some gift for him because of his entitlement of his achievement. So this is the gift. So the gift is given when there is an entitlement or when there is an occasion. Say for example, someone, it is the birthday of someone, of a child or someone, you give him the gift. You present gift to him. Why? Because it's an occasion. Or it's a marriage of someone, you give him the gift. Why? Because it's an occasion. So gifts are given only on two places. Never daily. It is only on occasion or entitlement. And Almighty Allah, when the 8th Imam says that aql and intelligence and reason is a gift, it will not come daily and it will not be given to anyone. It will be either on the occasion or either on entitlement. Now tonight is the occasion of the birth of Imam al-Ridha alayhi salatu wasalam, isn't it? So this is an occasion. And what power do we have just now in our authority? As Amir al-Mu'mineen says in Du'aakum ighfir liman la yamliku illa ad-du'a. Forgive the one who doesn't possess anything except du'a. So let us pray on the night of Imam al-Ridha's birth, taking the opportunity of this occasion, that may Almighty Allah grant us the complete reason and aql and understanding, so that we can be from the people who have received the gifts from Almighty Allah on the night of the birth of Imam al-Ridha alayhi salatu wasalam. So that is aql. So that's a gift. Intelligence is a gift from Almighty Allah. Now then Imam al-Ridha alayhi salatu wasalam goes ahead and he brings another facet to it. وَالْأَدَبُ كُلْفَةٌ. An Imam says that ethics are obtained by struggle. If a person struggles, he can achieve ethics. Then Imam alayhi salatu wasalam goes on, فَمَنْ تَكَلَّفَ تَكَلَّفَ الْأَدَبُ قَدَّرَ عَلَيْهِ. And whoever takes pain in acquiring ethics, he will get the ethics. وَمَنْ تَكَلَّفَ الْعَقْلِ لَمْ يَزْدَدْ بِذَٰلِكَ إِلَّا جَهْلًا. And whoever exerts effort in obtaining intelligence or aql, he will not get anything except increase in ignorance. Have you seen to the extent? What should we strive for? We should strive for not intelligence or aql, we should be striving for adab, ethics. Now the reason why the Imam alayhi salatu wasalam, at one hand he says that aql and intelligence is our goal, everyone wants aql, and aql is gift, and gift cannot be demanded, can it be? Only it's the kids when they tell the parents, oh, you have to give me a gift. It's kids, it's the children. But it's not normal. Why do the parents accept that, okay, that demand is accepted from the children? Because they are children. But normally you can't demand a gift, can you? Mari shadi thai chai mani gift up je? You can't demand. There is nothing like demanding a gift. You can't demand a gift. You can't say, come on, you have to give me a gift. Gift of what? If at all you ask for it, then it's no more a gift. You already asked for it. You begged for it. It's the payment against what you asked for. So, gift cannot be asked for. Almighty Allah and Imam says, alayhi salatu wasalam, in one place he says, intelligence and reason and aql is gift of Allah. And then he brings about ethics that a person can work on. That means that Imam is trying to tell us that if at all a person wants intelligence as a gift from Almighty Allah, he should work on his ethics and his morals. Once he gets his moral and ethics correct, he becomes entitled for the gift of intelligence and aql. So the secret behind getting the gift from Almighty Allah is either, because we cannot demand, we cannot ask. By asking, it's not the occasion. Almighty Allah will give it on the occasion or on the entitlement. And the entitlement comes for a person when he corrects his ethics. We pray to Almighty Allah to grant us tawfiq so that we can correct our ethics and our morals, so that we can be entitled for the aql, insha'Allah, and the intelligence. For the acceptance of this dua, please recite one loud salawat ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. And we are asking through this night and this occasion, why? Because Imam Rida alayhi salatu wasalam is just a granter of the desires. He just grants desires. A Turkish man comes to the haram of the 8th Imam, Imam Rida alayhi salatu wasalam. And in the Turkish language, he starts screaming and starts crying. There was a man over there who understood Turkish language. And he understood what the Turkish man was asking from Imam Rida. He said, I heard the Turkish man saying, oh Imam Rida, after such and such a war, I have lost my young son. If at all my son is alive, please let me see him. Allow me to see him. Let me meet him. And if at all he is dead, please give me the signs that he is dead. Because it's so many years now. And while he was crying and he completed his dua at the haram, he came out. And the man said that, I understood his dua, I just took him at home, I said, come on, I just felt pity on him. So I requested him to come to my house, so that I could just be good to him, because it was the desire of Imam al-Rida alayhi salatu wasalam. But I was thinking that the war has passed so many years, how will he find his lost son? But as soon as we came out of the haram of Imam al-Rida, I saw a tall boy who had just got fresh mustache, and this Turkish man and that new young boy, when they saw each other, they hugged each other, they started kissing each other. And then I asked him, "Oh, old man, who is this one?" He said, "This is my son whom I asked Imam al-Rida alayhi salatu wa salam." I asked Imam al-Rida and I came out, and Imam al-Rida gifted me. Believe me, mu'mineen, whoever presents any desire to Imam al-Rida alayhi salatu wa salam, it happens. I have seen it for myself, and I have seen it for several people. It has happened instantly. It's no delay. This is Thaminul A'immat al-Huda, Ali ibn Musa al-Rida, alayhi alafu al-tahiyyatu wa salam. The birth of such a leader was also special. Her mother was also a specially chosen one. And in the riwayat, it is strange that the facial features of all the a'imma were mentioned in the prior books, in the books before the Holy Quran. That is, in Suhuful Anbiya, in the books of Anbiya, the facial features of a'imma and the Prophet were mentioned, and we have a hadith on that. But we have never heard that there is a facial feature of any mother of the Imam. Except we have one riwayah, which is this riwayah that I had presented once, but because this is the birth night of the 8th Imam, I will present this riwayah again to you, that the facial features of the mother of the 8th Imam also were mentioned in the books of the Prophets. Past prophets, that is before the arrival and before the birth of our last Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. Therefore, we have to understand that the 8th Imam alayhi salatu wasalam's role was so important in history that even the facial features of her mother had to be described vividly in the books of Anbiya. The 7th Imam, Imam Musa al-Qadim alayhi salatu wasalam, he called this companion of his and he said, "Ahmad, can you come with me?" And they rode to a place where a person from the West, now it seems it was probably from the Europe, a person had come to sell maids. Imam first asked Ahmad, "Ahmad, have you heard about someone who is selling maids? He has come from West." He said, "No, Ibn Rasulullah." Imam said, "There is. Let me take you there." Then Imam went himself with Ahmad. And then Imam asked Ahmad to talk to this man, to the seller of maids, to the trader of maids, and he said, "Ask him to show us the variety of maids he has. We want to buy one of them." And each one, Ahmad says, and each one, the trader, you should show the Imam. Imam would say, "I don't need her. I don't want her. I don't want, I don't want." Then the trader said, "I don't have any more stock. I don't have any more maids." The Imam talked to the trader and he said, "You have hidden a maid and I need that maid." The man said, "I will not sell that maid. I don't have, she is ill, she is sick." Imam went away. And Ahmad said, "I left with the Imam." The next day Imam called me and he gave me a bag of coins. And he said, "Go again to the trader who is selling the maids and ask him that, and tell him that you are ready to pay any amount he demands for the maid whom he is not ready, he was not ready to sell yesterday." Ahmad says, "I went and I asked the trader, I told the trader that I'm ready to buy at whatever price you want to sell this lady." So he kept a very high price. And when we opened the bag that Imam had given me of the coins, the exact amount what had been demanded was there. I immediately handed over the money and he handed over to me the maid. Then he asked me, the trader told me, oh man, who was the one who accompanied you yesterday, who came to buy this maid yesterday? Ahmad says, I was fearful that I should not disclose the identity of the Imam. Probably this man will not be ready to sell the maid. Therefore what I did was that I said, oh, it was a Hashimite person. He was one of the noble men, so he just came to buy. So the trader said, now wait a moment and I will tell you my story. He said, this beautiful lady, I bought her and I was trying to take her away. And I saw one of the ladies of Ahlul Kitab, of the books. And she was knowledgeable about, and she had the knowledge of the prior books of Anbiya. She had read the books of Anbiya. She looked at this lady's features and she said, where are you taking her? So I told the lady that I was taking her to marry her. So the lady says, the facial features of this lady are mentioned in the books of Anbiya. And I am telling you, she is the mother of the king of the East and the West. Therefore you cannot marry her. Rather, it is your amana and it is the trust for you that you should go and deliver her in the Middle East, in Medina, because her rightful owner will be ready to come and buy at whatever price you demand. Allahu Akbar. Look at the signs, look at the signs. And then shortly afterwards she will beget a child who will be the king of the East and the West. Ahmad said, I heard the story and then I brought this maid to. Her name was Tuktam. I brought her to the seventh Imam alayhi salatu wasalam, and after some time Tuktam delivered, and the baby that was born now was Imam al-Ridha alayhi salatu wasalam. And Tuktam herself, there is a riwayah from the mother of the 8th Imam herself. Tuktam says that when I was bearing Imam al-Ridha alayhi salatu wasalam, at that time I was not feeling the burden and of the child. But at night whenever I used to sleep, I used to hear the zikr and qira'at al-Qur'an and the du'a. And I used to wake up fearing. Then when I would wake up, there would be no more recitation. When it was the time of the birth, I saw that the seventh Imam alayhi salatu wasalam had given me the good tidings that this child will be Hujjatullah and Baqiyatullah. So I knew what child I was bearing was the leader of the communities. He was the guide to the whole world. And then, now I will have to switch here to Urdu language so that the Urdu people, the senior citizens also can benefit from here, inshallah, if you recite one loud salawat ala Muhammad. Tuktam Imam Raza alayhi salatu wasalam ki walida ka naam hai, mother ka naam hai, alaykum salam. Kehti hai ke jab wiladat ka waqt nazdeek aaya to saatve imam ne mujhe bata diya tha ke jo beta aapko Allah ata karne wala hai wo mashriq aur maghrib ka badshah hoga. Wo badshah hukumat nahi karega, dilon ka badshah hoga, عقیدتوں کا بادشاہ ہوگا. یہ کعبہ عشق ہوگا جہاں پر عاشق طواف کریں گے. دور دراز سے لوگ جائیں گے اور اپنے ہوائج طلب کریں گے. باب الہوائج کا بیٹا تو ہوگا مگر خود باب الہوائج بھی ہوگا. کوئی بھی ایسا نہ ہوگا کہ جو اس کے دروازے پر آئے گا جو خالی جائے گا. سب کو بھر بھر کے دے گا اور اتنا دے گا, آئرے کو بھی دے گا, غیرے کو بھی دے گا. چنانچہ جیسے ہی विलादत का वक्त नजदीक आया, एक पर्दा हायल नूर का हुआ, फिर इसके बाद जब पर्दा छटा है तो मैंने देखा एक ताहिर बच्चा, पाक साफ सफाफ ताहिर मुताहर, सर सजदे में रखे हुए है, उंगली शहादत उठाए हुए है, कुछ कह रहा है, गोया कह रहा है अशहदु अल्ला इलाहा इल्लल्लाह व अशहदु अन्न जद्दी मुहम्मदुर रसूलुल्लाह व अशहदु अन्न अबी अमीर अल मुमिनीन अली वलीउल्लाह। अभी तो ये नूर छटा ही था, अभी तो ये बच्चा सजदे में ही था कि एक मर्तबा मैंने देखा मेरे शोहर को, तो तुम कहती है कि मैंने देखा मेरे शोहर, सातवें इमाम अलैहिस्सलाम हुजरे में दाखिल हुए, हुजरे में दाखिल होकर कहा तुक्तम तुम्हें मुबारक हो। मैं शर्मिंदा होकर सर झुकाकर मैंने सफेद कपड़े में बच्चे को लपेट कर उसके वालिद की गोद में तहवील दे दिया, उनके वालिद की गोद में दे दिया। तो इमाम ने उनके दाहिने कान में अजान कही, बाएं कान में इकामत कही, फिर फुरात का पानी मंगवाया, थोड़ा सा पानी बच्चे के मुंह में डालकर फिर मेरे हवाले करके कहा तुक्तम तुम्हें मुबारक हो, मशरिक व मगरिब के बादशाह की माँ बन गई। सलावात बर मोहम्मद व आल खुदावंद आलम। इस विलादत बासआदत के सदक़े से हम सब की दिली मुरादों को पूरा फरमा, जहाँ जहाँ मोमिनीन हैं उनकी दिली मुरादों को पूरा फरमा, हम सबको आपस में इत्तेहाद व इत्तेफाक की तौफीक इनायत फरमा। परवरदिगारा इस सईद मौके पर हम तुझसे दुआ करते हैं कि हमारे एथिक्स को करेक्ट करने की तौफीक हमें इनायत फरमा, ताकि हम उस गिफ्ट के मुस्तहिक बन सके जिसे अक्ल कहते हैं। परवरदिगारा इस के सदके से और इसी रात के सदके से हम तुझसे और भी गिफ्ट तलब कर रहे हैं। परवरदिगारा इस दुनिया में हमें इमाम रजा की ज्यारत नसीब फरमा, आखिरत में उनकी शफात नसीब फरमा। परवरदिगारा इमाम जमाना के जहूर में ताजील फरमा, हमको उनके नासिरीन में शुमार फरमा। बर मोहम्मद वाले मोहम्मद सलाम।